Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Lion Plays XCOM Enemy Within. Whoa, I'm going to use my microphone and move it back just a little bit because it seemed like I was shouting at you and I didn't mean it like that. So, we do have a mission I think that is ready for us to do straight away, unless I just finished that covert operation, in which case maybe we have to go back to the mission control and wait for something to come in, but it just dawned on me. You know, I record these videos in batches most of the time, so sometimes I just wake up in like a cold sweat 2 days after recording 6 videos and I'm like, well shit, we didn't upgrade our third mech at all. Or we didn't upgrade our second mech to the third level, so we have some options here, and we already have Fizzle Beef with this Electro Pulse. Everyone's telling me, Northern Line, you gotta use the Electro Pulse, man. It's so good against robotic enemies. I mean, think about it, if you have a Sectopod, it damages robotic ones. I thought it stunned robotic ones for one turn. Anyway, you can hurt a Sectopod a lot, and also in an area of effect, you know, if you had two of these things going on that had, like, concentric circles or circles that overlapped, you could do a ton of damage. But I also think I've never managed to use this Electro Pulse effectively because my positioning with Fizzle Beef is kind of bad. Maybe it's best to get the proximity launcher, and that might give me the option to actually hurt some people. And actually, what we could do is, why don't we build, in addition to that proximity launcher, we'll build like a mimic beacon. Can you throw it or do you just put it down? I guess we'll see. And we'll replace one of our frag grenades with a mimic beacon once we get started here. We've got a couple of days till some satellites go up. We have a council report. I expect this to be an A. Alright, good. We didn't lose anybody. India is kind of close. We have a staggering amount of money now. Let me check on something. He's not going to shut up here. So, what's our satellite capacity? It is 13 out of 13, so we either finish this month, or we risk losing India, or we do like a mission there. I think we'll be fine. I'm not really worried about losing one country. I'm just trying to think here. Okay, there's something people have told me to get, an item or a not an item. I should say a. I'm pretty sure it's a foundry upgrade that gives you the ability to give your mechs an inventory slot, or is that something you get on the there might be something you get when the mechs actually level up, but let's see what we've got here anyway. Tactical rigging. This one enables soldiers to bring a second item into battle. That seems awesome. How long is that going to take? We don't really have anything else to spend too much money on, I think. Probably should give Beeps the particle cannon, I guess. Don't really want sentinel drone. What about shaped armor? The invaders' mechanized cybersuits are, of course, somewhat more advanced than our own. By examining the interfaces between the armored shells and the cores, we can improve the overall armor design. This could increase the tactical survivability for all of our mechanized forces. I don't even know if we really need that, but sure, why not? It's another 300, so we spent a lot of our money so far. What about improved pistol? We don't use these that often, but still. Increase the aim of all soldiers using a pistol. That's not that useful, I guess. What about advanced flight? We can improve the system flight capacities of the Archangel armor, which our sniper has, and the hover shiv design, considerably increasing their maximum flight time in combat. So I think it gives more fuel. That's not really worth it, considering what we've got going on here. Let us build a particle. I think it's called a particle cannon. Anyway, come down here. There we go. That will be outfitted on Beeps, and I think everybody else is basically good to go. I suppose we could build a couple Psy armor. Actually, we could only build one Psy armor. But we might as well. Okay, so let's build one of those. That's one way to use basically all of your weapon or all of your money right off the bat. Why don't we build a Ghost armor as well? And what we're going to use this for is to, we'll use this for, like, an assault or something like that. I don't know. Might as well mix it up, right? Okay, so we'll see what comes up next. Tactical rigging. And, well, the council report soon. Basically, yes, this is pretty much exactly what we're waiting for. We have Muton Elite, Seeker, Mectoid, Sectoid Commander, Chrysalid, Cyberdisc. And it's in Canada, so, you know, somewhere in Quebec or, like, Labrador there. Cool! Never been. Well, I've been to Quebec. I haven't been to Labrador. So, I guess I'm going to give Zhang the Mimic Beacon. Does he seriously? No, he's got Titan armor on. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to give him the Mimic Beacon. He takes two of those. I thought he could take like a frag grenade and a Mimic Beacon. That's fine. Whatever. Android Cactus with the Needle Grenade. It might even be best to give you like an Arc Thrower or something like that, because then you could capture the aliens. But the Needle Grenade maybe, because you can hit multiple people simultaneously. What's her health? 23. 9 plus 14. With the Ghost armor, it is 17. That's a little scarier, but still, that's probably fine. And I thought we had... Oh, we have Psy Armor that goes on Florence Nightingale. Current health 19. And if we give her the Psy Armor, then her health is 15. Dr. Bowen is confident that this soldier has the power to interact with the alien device. Oh, now that I've given her Psy Armor, she can actually go to the Golem Chamber. Okay, well, we'll do this mission, and then I guess we'll sort that out. And that might be the indication that we're about to do the final Temple Ship Assault. So that would be interesting to get done. I don't want to see the series end, but it has, you know, relative to the first series, like when I first did this, I'm pretty sure that Enemy Unknown only took me like 30 videos, I think. But, you know, Enemy Within adds in, obviously, a staggering amount more content, so... I'm not surprised that the series has taken longer. I don't think I've really dragged my heels that much relative to how I did in Enemy Unknown. But anyway, I'm glad that it's taken us a long time because it's a really good game and I've really enjoyed playing through it again. This is this will not be... Oh my god, I didn't give Beeps the new weapon. Okay, well, it's unlikely to make a difference, but still, that's stupid of me. This shouldn't come as a surprise, but... you know, when it comes time to choose what to record, I do play favorites, and XCOM Enemy Within is definitely one of those games that I play, like, first off, because I'm like, okay, well, I'm really excited to see, like, how the series goes. And I know, there's a grapple on the Ghost Armor? I had no idea. I know I'm not the best player of it at all, but I do, like, playing it through again, like, this has inspired me to maybe do a classic playthrough kind of on my own time, so that when I struggle, I can still maybe survive in spite of that. Or maybe, like, just restart in spite of that without actually irritating anybody. Telekinetic field we just got. Okay, so we can already see basically how this run is shaping up, or how this turn is shaping up at the very least. Apologies, I haven't had my first cup of coffee in the morning. And, you know, if you don't drink coffee, if you do, you probably know what I'm talking about, but... If you don't drink coffee, and I didn't until I was like 23 and started work, or I was like 22 and I started working as an English teacher in South Korea, and was like, I need some kind of legal drug to deal with children on a daily basis. And yeah, I was like, ooh, grown-ups gotta have their coffee. Wow, that's pathetic that you rely on a substance for, you know, energy and blah 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 blah. Now I'm like, give me that shit as soon as you IV it, direct line it right into my fucking cerebellum. I don't care, I need it. So there's our meld canister. I think it's pretty unlikely at this point that we are going to need the meld canister. Why does she suck? She can't climb this ladder? Oh, there's a ramp, but luckily she has jet boot modules, so we actually can send her in here. Really frustrating that I didn't give her the particle cannon, but let's be honest, it's not the first time, is it? So we've encountered a mechtoid. The infuriating thing about this is obviously that it's on Overwatch, and there's not going to be... Okay, I was going to say, you better have a better chance to hit the mechtoid. A couple of infuriating things. It's on Overwatch, so I guess ideally I would like to use Android Cactus to... Oh, we've already used Android Cactus, but she can still run and gun. But can she actually, like, make it over here? She can. Okay, so that's what we're going to do. We're going to run and gun her over here. I'm not even sure if ghosting will help her. But we really want to kill this mechtoid before the sectoid commander can actually do the psychic shield. And if we miss one of these, I don't know if it's going to be possible. All right. Android Cactus is just such a goddamn champ always that I don't know what I would do without her. She's been very good on this series so far. Now, it's possible, albeit unlikely, that I could maybe come over here and see the sectoid commander. Obviously, I cannot. That's okay, though. I'll move over here nonetheless. This is a total waste of fuel, but this is an interior mission, so it's pretty unlikely that I'm going to need to fly too much once we get inside of the ship. That being said, now I'm starting to wish that we'd researched extra fuel, especially if I'm not actually going to take the extra weapon with me that I had built. You're going to go on Overwatch for sure. Fizzlebeef, like, just can't... He can't get anywhere. What I might be able to do is, like, toss a grenade in, but I think we'll just do this. And what I'm concerned about is Android Cactus being taken over by the psychic sectoid commander. But I think he'll probably just run away. If I had to guess, that's what I would do if I was him, just in the interest of self-preservation. No, he's still going to do a mind control. It is on Android Cactus, and it worked. So, you know, it's not the end of the world. It could be the end of the world, but it's not the end of the world yet. But we need to absolutely take out the sectoid commander. 32% chance to hit is not good enough. What if I get... Like, I don't know if this is gonna... If I'm gonna have a shot here. I think... Okay, I do. So headshot is gonna give me a 60% chance to kill. Oh! Jude Law! I love you so much. After, you know, initially kind of muted praise, you have basically turned into my favorite member on the squad. Minus Fizzle Beef! Because, oh, excuse me. I do not remember there being a sectopod on this mission. 91, 91, 60. Okay. This is real bad. What I can do is land a rocket all the way back there. And this should kill at least both of the drones and anger the sectoid. Remember, we have the, like, special rockets that now turn corners. Unfortunately, we can't really see it. Oh, no, we still can. There we go. Oh, fuck me. It didn't hit the sectopod. So I really, really want to get Florence Nightingale out of there, since she is, like, obviously one of my most powerful troops. If we end up losing her, at least we do still have Zhang, but still, who else is here? Beeps has got some turns. Well, what does she have? She has proximity mine, restorative mist. I'm just gonna move her over here, and hopefully she can at least get a shot. Nope, but she'll go on Overwatch then. And unfortunately, you know what? This is a good time to use the smoke grenade, I think. We're just gonna pop this down right here. Probably should have taken the meld canister first, just in case it actually explodes on this turn. She is behind full cover, so, you know, between that and the smoke, she's probably okay-ish. We'll see, though. Sectopod real fucking annoying. Can the Sectopod fire twice and then go on Overwatch? I think I've had, like, bad experiences where that is actually a possibility. So, shot number one comes in. It's the, like, beam, and it misses. That is huge. It's possible that she could be two shot. I don't think she could be one shot. Oh, wow, that's it. Okay. Alright, so, you know, I think a Shredder rocket is, like, probably in order. But I've actually got it. Oh, maybe it was, like, slightly out of range. If so, that's fine. Well, Nightingale is going to be taking a shot. That's for sure. Fizzle Beef. I can get him in here. He's obviously going to be taking a shot as well. Or shooting a grenade, depending on what his odds are. Wow, okay. I guess the Sectopod is just too far away. That's kind of bullshit. Beeps can definitely get in there. Alright, Beeps. Get in the smoke, because you're going to be protected there. Oh, are you serious? Like, maybe it just gets like an automatic reaction shot to anything within range. Well, luckily there was a miss there. And that's good news for obvious reasons. We have a 47% chance to do like 5 damage. I think Sectopods take half damage. Since the new patch. Or not the new patch, but the DLC. And if that's the case, that's bullshit and I hate everything. Who else do we have left? Okay, Android Cactus, obviously very important to our chances for success. Our sniper, I'm just gonna move here, and then we're gonna turn flight off. She doesn't even have a shot. That is surprising to me. Okay. Exit flight mode. Probably should, like, hunker down. Actually, you know, I'm just gonna move her behind this. I could have overwatched with her, but it doesn't really matter. We can do suppression. It takes a free shot if the target moves and reduces the target's aim. I think that's the right idea while we get everybody else kind of into position here. There's no place else I can really put Zhang to make him better in this situation, so we'll dash with him, even though that might seem like a terrible move. And I think we'll put... we'll do suppression last. Question is, where can Android Cactus go to simplify this? I can't even run and gun with her, so never mind. We'll just move her out here for now. And maybe on the next turn I can run and gun, and with lightning reflexes we can also bait out an Overwatch. Sorry, not rapid fire, Overwatch, there we go. And Fizzlebeef will Overwatch, and O'Connell will... I don't think, like collateral damage doesn't make any sense to me here. We'll probably take the shot. Nightingale, we'll take the shot first, and then we'll use suppression. Come on, this would be a good hit. God damn it. Well, I'm not even sure if the particle cannon has a better chance to hit anyway. So here comes suppression. So this thing, if it moves, we'll get a free reaction shot, which is not that important. Mostly, I just want to reduce its aim so that when it takes a shot, it has a less chance of hitting. That looks pretty good, though. Oh, another big miss. I don't think I've been hit by a sectopod yet on this mission, or sorry, on this playthrough, which is of staggering importance. Oh, now I'm immediately going to regret my decision. What do we have here? Another laser beam. Another big miss. Okay, so we'll just keep trying to mitigate it, I guess. There's another melt. Oh, we lost the melt canister? We lost the melt canister I was standing right in front of. That is inexcusable. That's me being an idiot, basically. All right, Zhang. Shredder rocket or real rocket? Real rocket does 9 damage. Shredder rocket does 6 damage and causes increased damage from everything else. So I think we'll fire a shredder rocket in here in the interest of making our other units do more damage. Please actually do damage. There we go. It only did 4 damage because of the sectopod's armor plating, I guess. But still, that's okay because now everything else will do more damage. Just try. We can still use suppression here. Okay, Android Cactus. She can ghost with 8. Becomes invisible, lasts 1 turn or until attack is made. Alright, so we're gonna do this, and this should allow me to get very close. I mean, I'm just gonna take like a shot immediately after this. So that might seem very silly, but I think this is a good idea. It might still bait out a reaction shot. Maybe it was a bad idea because it doesn't allow me to bait out the reaction shot. I don't know. What's our rapid fire? 2 times 58. I'll take it. First one's a hit. Second one, a miss. But okay, we got another 6 damage. If we can do 6 damage per person, obviously she's revealed. If we can do 6 damage per person, we'll be in a good position. Headshot's not ready. She doesn't have a shot. Are you fucking kidding me? What is blocking her shot here? Maybe, like, it's really deceptive how far away this thing is. Grace O'Connell can take 2 shots, so at 47, I've got to try. We could be in a real serious problem here because Android Cactus is so unprotected. Okay, 2 misses from Grace O'Connell is just not okay right now. Nightingale is going to do suppression, almost certainly. We're going to just form a wall here, I guess. Oh, this is going to be a reaction shot. Please don't hit, because Fizzlebeef could actually... Oh, shit. That's not that bad, actually. 8 damage could be worse. We can fire a grenade in there, or we can take a shot. 68 is Fizzlebeef's magic number. Pretty good. 7 damage. My god, this thing is proving to be kind of a pain in the dick, isn't it? Is this half cover? No. If there's half cover, I'd move into it, because I could get a shot out of it. Otherwise, Overwatch. There we go. Okay, so that's good. Because half cover counts as full cover for our sniper. We'll do suppression again, which should reduce its aim. That looked like a direct hit to me, but... oh, good. I forgot he had, like, the nanobots or what have you. All right. Let's see what Sectopod chooses to do here. Suppression, so far, has helped me out a lot in reducing the aim of these enemies. I worry about Android Cactus here. Oh, big miss. Okay. I don't know why the Sectopod has been such a pain in the ass. Well, I mean, I know why it's been such a pain in the ass. It's because it's a sectopod, but still, luckily we probably won't encounter too many more of these over the course of the game. Okay. Fizzlebeef takes another 10 damage. Still alive and relatively well. Wait, was that... No, that was Grace O'Connell. Okay, well, disregard that then. Sniper is going to be our first shot here. 55% chance of a critical, 75% chance to hit. Alright, that it wasn't a critical, but it hit. That's good. That's very good. Android Cactus has 2 times 58 again. 1 hit would be great. 2 hits would be incredible. Okay, thank the fucking Lord. That was a real problem. We will reload. We'll overwatch when necessary. And you should probably reload, but I guess you have double tap available right now. You're just gonna hunker down. You're not going to do anything. She being Nightingale in this situation, is going to heal. Why does it seem like this person hasn't been hit? Like, Grace O'Connell has been hit, right? It's Nightingale's health that I'm seeing? Is that it? I don't know. There we go. That's what I was looking for. So, that heals 10? Holy shit. I think it's because she has that metal, I guess. Zhang, we're just going to... I might even move you... Oh, I can't move you up, so we're just going to have you overwatch... And you're just gonna end turn, I guess. And Fizzlebeef, I want to heal him, but he's also gonna heal himself. Okay, we have 2 Seekers. Did color me fucking scared. after the sectopod and mectoid nonsense we just dealt with, I am extremely happy to be dealing with some enemies that are a little bit more my speed. The meld, not worrying me at all. Everyone's healing up and getting some extra ammo here. She is in a not great position, so I'm actually going to move her back. She's not going to be behind cover, but she will be near her teammates, which is maybe more important. The music sounds like I have vision on somebody, but I'm pretty sure I don't. The seekers will definitely come out of hiding, but that's okay. It looked like we had two reaction shots on two different seekers, by the way. Oh my god. There we go, we got one hit there. That'll be enough. But I thought we had another shot on another seeker. Maybe I'm crazy, though. We'll see. I don't know if all of these seekers are dead. Okay, let's take a quick look at the layout of the ship here. That looks like the back. Well, we can always like cheat and see how far it goes. Like pretty far, actually, so maybe we should check out that direction first. That's why I actually kind of hate when the UFO missions turn into these like big battleships, because it makes it so much more difficult to kind of navigate and see where the hell you're supposed to go. And certainly, you do not want to split up into search parties, I think, because, you know, we still have, like, Muton elites and berserkers and stuff like that. You want to have all of your forces available, if possible, to deal with that kind of nonsense and riffraff that can show up. Mind you, what else do we have on this mission? We have sectopods. We have, yeah, we haven't seen a cyberdisc yet. So we have, like, Muton elite, berserker, cyberdisc. And I think that's basically all that really worries me. And that's good, because I want to give Florence Nightingale a chance to use her newfound technical skills. Actually, I apologize, by the way. I did not know that you actually needed Psy armor in order to use the Gollop Chamber. It's been a while since I played Enemy Unknown, so I hope you'll forgive me for that. It might seem like I was just trying to drag it out a little bit longer. In some ways, that's true, because I'm enjoying the game, but also looking forward to that temple assault, because it's a real difficult one. It's a challenging mission. Do we hear something, or are we just standing still? Looks like the other meld canister is through here. Well, if my time playing Enemy Within has taught me anything, it's that meld canisters quite frequently have enemies around them, protecting them. Sometimes yes, sometimes no. We're able to dash in here, and this is important because now we can get into a very kind of advanced position before opening this door. And it'll only take us one more turn. I'm not really interested in the meld canister, but I'm interested in the fact that there might be enemies around the meld canister that could, you know, provide me with a way to basically finish the mission, because as of right now, obviously that has been slow going. We've only killed 5 enemies so far, and there's probably at least 12 to 16, if I had to guess. That's just par for the course, I think. Because you think, like, enemies come in certain waves. Whenever you have a sectopod, you have a drone or two around it. Maybe it's guaranteed to be two, I'm not sure. Whenever you have a mectoid, you always have a sectoid commander around it. I'm guessing that the Muton Elite Berserker configuration that we're going to have is going to be, like, one Berserker, two Muton Elite. So, you know, you just run the math on that. Similarly, Cyberdisc will probably have a drone near it. And that puts us somewhere in the vicinity of, you know, like another 10 to 11 enemies, maybe? I don't know. Is there a seeker behind me? Is that what just happened? Or was that a computer that just exploded? Weird. Okay. Again, considering I'm not worried at all about this meld canister, what I'm going to do is just get in a more advanced position again to get in front of this door. And we're going to overwatch everybody if that seeker's around. I want to be sure that I can actually take it out. Who is this? This is Jude Law. She needs to get in a cover spot for sure, so that she can actually get a shot on the next turn. And yeah, it'd be nice to get Jang up here. He has another rocket available. We didn't get a chance to use our Mimic Beacon or our proximity weapons yet. That's fine. I think the way that's likely going to work is that we'll have like a... we'll throw a battle scanner, so we'll see the enemies before the enemies see us. Okay, this is bad, and it's bad because the Cyberdisc does damage when it explodes. But maybe we won't take reaction shots against the Cyberdisc. Do I get a free reaction shot again against, okay, well, okay, that was actually a pretty good turn from the aliens when you think about it, but, we're very close together here. 100% chance to kill the Seeker. Let's get that done. It doesn't explode. She's gonna be catching her breath for a turn. So we have the Cyberdisc. That's the problem. I think we'll just kill the other drone, just to simplify this. So now all we have is this Cyberdisc, at our disposal. If possible, we would obviously like to get everybody out of the vicinity So, and I'm just gonna back people up here. I really should have used Android Cactus for that. Fizzlebeef is getting smashed in the fucking face on this turn. That's fine though. Okay, so we'll move Android Cactus back a little bit, and then we'll move Beeps back a little bit. And Jude Law is standing like right there, so that's really bad for business. Yeah, we'll move you back a little bit. Okay, now we can't move Florence Nightingale, but I think she's out of the fire range anyway. Cyberdisc time. Too many S phonemes in there. Well, okay, we killed it very easily with just Android Cactus. Explosion didn't hurt anybody. Kind of a pain in the dick, though. Alright, let's use Florence Nightingale to heal up Roll Fizzlebeef here. Inarguably the most important member of my squad so far on the entire series. Maybe not on these missions, though. Nightingale's now extremely important. Android Cactus is remarkably strong, and Jude Law holding the fort down as well. Speaking of which, we're going to put her back in the kind of advanced position that she was in earlier. And maybe we'll be able to move her and then use a battle scanner on the next turn to figure out if there are some extra aliens inside of this room. I heard some movement in there, and that frightens me. Let's move in. Oh, there we go. We've got two chrysalids and a meld canister that is apparently floating in the sky. Well, we do have Archangel armor, so that might be possible for us to do something about. Okay, well, this is obviously Grenade Town. I think. Or, actually, you know what? It's almost certainly in our best interest to just move back. And this might be a really good time, if I do say so myself, for Grace O'Connell to throw down a that's kinetic strike, to throw down a proximity mine. It does 8 damage to enemies that move within the mine's detection range. Okay, this will not hit us, thankfully. So let's try this out. That looks like it might hit us, right? I think maybe we're just outside of the range. Let's emphasize the fact that we're outside of that range and kind of overwatch ourselves over here, shall we? That's a shredder rocket. I am hitting all the wrong keys today. Sure, we're gonna overwatch. Pardon me, that was disgusting. We're gonna overwatch everybody that has a chance to overwatch, and this should take out one chrysalis, and that will compensate for, you know, the possibility that we don't kill both of them. We lost the meld canister, and they didn't come in? Alright, well then, we take Zhang, and we throw our mimic beacon, like right here. And the aliens come to us. Alright, and then we just go. I don't even want to go on Overwatch because I'm worried that I would actually kill the aliens before the proximity mine goes off. But we probably should in the interest of being smart here. I'll reload with the people that can afford to reload on this turn. And everybody else, you can just go on Overwatch. Alright, we actually only have 2 Overwatches, but I'm relatively confident in this like Claymore setup that I've got going on here. I don't want to walk through the proximity mine. I'm pretty sure it won't blow up and kill me. But it might, right? Don't kill him! Don't kill him! That's gonna miss. Oh, okay. The proximity mine just went off, I think. The mimic beacon's still there. I wonder if the other, yeah, I was gonna say, maybe the other chrysalid will just, like, run towards us now. This would be a hell of a shot, Nightingale. Yeah, it's a little too distant. Well, the proximity mine worked totally fine. This chrysalid has now come over to this mimic beacon. That was disconcerting. It may have actually been able to do, like, another attack there. So, against my better judgment, I'm gonna send Nightingale out here. She doesn't have vision, and I'm a dummy. Okay, Fizzlebeef, why don't you come out even further then? Alright, do we have vision with Nightingale now? Like, well, we're gonna get the kill anyway. This won't be the end of the mission, though. Did we lose the other meld? We did. Okay. Well, we should start moving forwards, I guess. This is maybe the back of the ship, but that's okay. I'm just gonna move Nightingale in a little further. And yeah, I mean, it looks like the back of the ship, but whatever, right? It's not that big of a deal. We can always come back in the other direction. This is how a lot of these UFO missions this late in the game end up going, just because there's so much goddamn space to cover. Good, you know, Chrysalis at this point, I'm almost disappointed that it took us so long to actually deal with them, because they're pretty easy to take out once you get past like the early stages of the game, obviously in the early game and on the Newfoundland mission, which is just nuts, but in the early game, they're pretty difficult because they can one-shot you and they can also turn soldiers against you, and that's kind of horrifying. But it's not that bad right now. I keep hearing like mechanized movement that scares the shit out of me. Let's take Android Cactus. And we're going to run and gun her, like, all the way out here. So this is super dangerous, because if there's anything out here, she's going to be very much in harm's way. But it doesn't look like there is anything out here. And that's the edge of the map, so... cool. You're going to Overwatch. Now, this is where I'd break all of my previous advice. Remember I had said, you know, don't split up into search parties. We're going to split up into search parties. And I'm just trying to think of how I would do this if I was me, and I am, so I guess it's easy enough for me to sort out, isn't it? I think we'll examine the perimeter of the ship with a lot of people, and then we'll have, these are just going to be like scouting parties, basically. And then we'll have other people examine the inside of the ship, because there are lots of areas we actually did not check out for ourselves. And I think like one mech is good enough to not get killed. I think three soldiers, especially with one of them being a killer psychic support, one of them being Jude Law, and the other one being a psychic heavy, we're pretty good to go there. And Android Cactus, we'll just move her to the one of the perimeters. And cool, Zhang, you're gonna. The other reason I'm putting three on the inside and then like two total on there, four on the inside and two total on the outside. Never mind, we're gonna go this way instead. Is because I was thinking it was more likely that we were actually going to discover enemies inside, but it looks like outside is actually more likely at this point. So, yeah, we're just going to throw her on Overwatch, and this could be the last wave of enemies that we end up taking on. So, I'm going to just dash over to this side as quickly as possible. And I'm going to be out of position, there's no question about it. But if we're just fighting a few berserkers or a berserker and a few Muton Elite, I don't consider it to be likely that it is a problem. Could be wrong, though. In any case, there's certainly no rush to finish this mission because we have already fucked up. She's right there, okay. We've already fucked up and lost all our meld, but we're already so late in the game that probably doesn't matter that much either. Probably should have at least put her on Ghost, if I'm going to give her Ghost armor. But, you know, what's done is done. Fizzlebeef's not even going to get close for this engagement. He's just like, fuck this shit, I'm out of here. I'm done carrying this team, my mechanized back is sore. Proximity grenades actually do seem very useful, though. At least if you are able to throw a Mimic Beacon and actually get aliens to come to them. 8 damage is not a lot, but it's enough to kill a Chrysalid, as you saw. Okay, that's the end of this turn. I imagine that we will be encountering some aliens on the next turn. So I'm going to move Beeps out here and hopefully we'll get some vision. And I can always... okay, there is our Mectoid, which is surprising to me. I wish I hadn't moved so far because now I can't do the sweet-ass punch. So I'm not worried about the Sectoid at all. The Mectoid, annoying. 9 damage straight to his face, though, is a lot. And will we be able to get the kill? Jude Law's over there. I think it's feasible we could get the kill. Lightning reflexes means the first shot will always miss. So I'm actually going to come like all the way in here. This will cause... good. I thought maybe the Sectoid would have Overwatch as well, but Lightning reflexes means we can bait out this Overwatch. And that means this Mectoid is dead. He's not going to live. Rapid fire will just destroy him. 2 times 98, yeah. Oh, man, we even critted him on the first one. Okay. That might kill the Sectoid as well. Nope. Okay. Can I take another shot afterwards? Because I didn't use rapid fire. Of course not. And then we'll come down here with Zhang, and that'll be the end of the weird little Sectoid situation here. But certainly, we tore through that very easily, even only having like half our squad. We still do not know where the Berserkers are, and that's... I mean, it's not worrying. It's just annoying. Remember, these UFO missions used to be like, what, maybe 15, 20 minutes maximum? Now we're approaching like 40 minutes, might even end up ending it in the like 45 minute range, which is just crazy town. For these early missions, it gives you some incentive to not just like farm these missions for resources and actually go to that temple mission, I guess. Which is, you know, sometimes it takes a little bit of extra prodding to do that because it's a... a difficult mission in and of itself. Still do not hear anybody. Anything, I guess. And this is basically where we started. So I am moving slowly through here, which is maybe a little bit more precautionary than necessary, but I don't think it's the worst idea. We're gonna move around this side of the ship. If I know XCOM, then our aliens, there'll be more aliens than I expect, and they'll be in the last place I would think to look, which is, in this case, probably the north face of the ship. I struggle with cardinal directions. If the ship was a map right now, it would be in the north direction, which is at the top. Anyway, we are going, that looks like a sarcophagus there. But we're gonna make our way through here, and pretty shortly, what I've gotta remember, it's been 35 minutes since I made this mistake, so it's easy for me to forget about it. I've gotta remember 100% to give the particle cannon to Beeps. She's been fine, she's landed a couple hits, which is better than she normally does, let's be honest. Do we hear something? People have turned around. Oh, there we go. So they are at the back of the ship, okay. Maybe that's the aft, I don't know. That's the sarcophagus that I was talking about, by the way. Let me click on the ye old fizzle beef here. Yeah, I've got to remember to give her the particle cannon. I don't know why she's so bad. Like, I want to give her a mech or something like that. I just want to give her a hug, because she's clearly not cut out for this program, but, you know, desperate times call for desperate measures, I guess. She's Irish, and Fizzlebeef is Irish, so I've created this kind of, you know, concocted this narrative in my head where they're, like, brother and sister from Ireland, but, like, he's always been the, like, you know, I play, what's a popular Irish sport? Sheep shearing. I play sheep shear. I'm just joking, by the way, if you were Irish. I guess, you know, soccer / football or rugby might be one of them. Anyway, you'd think for as much as I play as an Irish count in CK2, I would learn more about the culture. Drinking? That's an offensive stereotype. I apologize for that. Who doesn't like alcohol, though? And I'm going to take Zhang down over here. She was like the nerdy one, and that's why she's in like a robot, but he didn't want to be in a robot. He wanted to take like Zhang's role. He wanted to be the psychic heavy that was going to save the world, but then, you know, like his legs got cut off by a chrysalid or something like that, and they thought he was going to die, but instead they did like this life-saving operation. Anyway, so she resents him and he resents her, but of course they're going to have to band together in order to save the mission. Fizzlebeef's going to give Beeps some important tips, I think, and then, as a result of that, you know, he's gonna die, but she's gonna use his legacy to actually finish the what the XCOM project is aimed for so long. That's how I see this going if this was a movie, which it is. If only I could write my own XCOM scripts, man. Between that and the Fizzlebee Florence Nightingale romance from earlier before I had to restart the classic playthrough. Florence Nightingale has sprint so she can move so many extra tiles. So far so good, I guess. Why are you so far away? Like, Zhang, you're gonna have no chance to even factor into this final confrontation. But, Android Cactus might be able to run and gun and get herself back into position. Well, I guess she doesn't need to run and gun, she can just dash. It's not like the Overwatch is actually effective right now. Good news! Climbing the ladder! I'm surprised you didn't just punch a hole in the spaceship and wait for it to teeter over until you could walk up it as if it was a ramp. I have a feeling we're gonna find some aliens inside of here. I actually thought they were going to pop open the door. So, let's pop this open, and I imagine we're going to find berserkers in here. And mutons. Are they seriously, like, in the blind spot there? That would be pretty crazy. Fizzlebeef can walk in, so I'm actually going to use him as, like, a battle scanner. A glorified battle scanner. No, we've got basically clear vision all around. And I do not see an alien. Wilco. Do we see aliens on this side? Not really, okay. Weird, for one, but also a little bit disconcerting. I was pretty sure that they were going to be in this room, and if they were in that room, nowhere to hide, right? They'd be very easy to take out. Cactus. I'm going to run. There's no point in running gunning. I don't know why I have this obsession with running gun. I use it for scouting when, if I know that there's no enemies in here because I already have vision, I should just dash. That's, like, objectively true, I think. Now, Fizzlebeef came up this way, so I don't think we're going to aggro aliens by sending Beeps around this way, but this will allow us to get two different angles on the attack, assuming they're kind of over this ridge. And Jude Law, I'm actually going to Archangel you. Archangel, Archangel. It's the best I could do. And we're going to send her up on top of this roof. And is she totally out of fuel? Is that what's up with that? Because if not, I'd actually like her to just stay in the sky as long as possible. Okay, well, never mind. Hey, we actually do have vision now. I don't think our sniper's going to get a shot at these guys. These are elites, not berserkers. Now our sniper might actually get a shot on them, which is very good news from me. Oh, no. She'll get one shot, I think. There we go. No double tap is available. 70% critical means that this is probably a kill, and the kill cam tells me that I am indeed correct. Okay, and then we just got to get one more. This should be easy. Well, you know what? Android Cactus has done so much good stuff for us. Let's have her come out here. There is an Overwatch, but Lightning Reflexes should... Oh, there's no Overwatch. Oh, that's really bad news for you. 80% critical chance on rapid fire. 100% chance to hit. So this is done. Hopefully that's the end of the mission. This has been a long one. Yep, no meld canisters, but apart from that, pretty good. Man, long episode to start this off here. Well, you're welcome, Labrador. No longer the part of Canada that so few people actually think about, except people who actually live there. I'm not trying to be insulting. I meant like in the world stage. That actually came across kind of more insulting. This lady has gone on like every mission that I've done for the past 20 or something, but she still has not leveled up all the way to Colonel. She's the only one in my squad. In fact, that Big McLarge Huge should be out here. He's just, okay, let's look at this. How many missions did Jill Fisher go on? 10? 11. So she went on 11 missions. She's a major. Grace O'Connell went on 20 missions. Still a major. Still waiting on the Colonel abilities. Anyway, as always, thanks for watching Northern Lion Plays XCOM Enemy Within. If you like the episode, make sure to click the like button. It will help me out a great deal. And of course, if you want to see more daily XCOM Enemy Within, especially as the series winds to a close, make sure to click that subscribe button and get them delivered to your YouTube homepage every single day. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.